Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the University of Central Lancashire, I'm delighted to warmly welcome you to Preston Guildhall and to this graduation ceremony. On this special day, we're here to proudly celebrate the achievements of our students from the School of Forensic and Investigative Sciences and the School of Psychology. I now call upon the Interim Vice Chancellor, Professor Mike Thomas, to give his address.
Good morning, everybody. Chancellor, Mr. Mayor, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, and our graduates. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to this graduation ceremony at which we acknowledge and celebrate the achievements of our new graduates. Please forgive me for focusing my words today on you, our graduates here, because this is your day, and I'm delighted that so many of you have been able to attend, and I hope you enjoy both the ceremony itself and I'm sure the celebrations afterwards with your families, colleagues and friends. It's customary for a Vice-Chancellor to use the graduation event as an opportunity to comment on economic affairs or politics or to speak about the university in general. So I don't want to pontificate, I won't do that sort of speech, I want to talk to you, our most important participants, our graduates, and also say a few words about our subject disciplines and staff. But forgive me if I just digress for one quick sentence. I think you students today who are leaving us as graduates should be aware that at 11 o'clock tonight, there's an embargo at the moment, news will be released to say that you will be graduates of a university that's in the top 4% of the world. So congratulations. Today marks an important day in your lives. It's bringing your studies to a successful conclusion. But it's also the beginning of a journey, and I know the personal characteristics that got you here. Your energy and your commitment, your tenacity, your curiosity, and your resilience. And I know that those will be important for the rest of your lives. And it's not a simple thing to talk about your careers and where you will end up. I could say that success and happiness are intertwined and represent different things to different people. So some of you here will gain titles such as professor or vice chancellor or doctor or entrepreneur or professional or director or manager or head. All signs of success and achievement. But things like family, friends and interests outside of work also play a key role in a fulfilling life. So my advice to you is do what you enjoy, choose a career you want to do, and if you don't know what to do, make the most of every single opportunity that comes along. Don't let chances and opportunities pass you by. There is that old saying that opportunity knocks on your door. Well, don't wait for it. Open the door, look down the road, go to the corner. If you see opportunity come, run towards it and grab it before it reaches you. And don't be afraid or unwilling to try different things. Forge your own path. Be ready to compromise when you need to, in love and in work and in friendship and in your life generally. And take setbacks as just a sign you need to try a different route rather than stop what you are doing. Seek to make a difference and get involved. You are the future leaders of our businesses, our industries and our communities. Do good for others. And whatever you choose to do, make sure you always do it to the best of your abilities, with enthusiasm and desire, and savour fun and happiness when you experience them, just for the sheer simple joy of fun and happiness. Finally, I urge you to develop your thinking and your views on life. Be strong in your core beliefs, but do so with compassion and tolerance and kindness and openness to others. I would like to say a few words about our subject provision here at the university. It's been another good year for our School of Forensics and Investigative Sciences. It coordinated the university's investment in the state-of-the-art Hydra Minerva Suite, which is opened by Steve Finnegan, an honorary fellow of the university and chief constable of Lancashire Constabulary. The foundation degree in policing were voted teaching team of the year, and the school has progressed its internationalization with students visiting the USA, the Czech Republic, and Poland. The school has made a strategic decision through the Chartered Institute of Building Services Engineers and collaboration with Hong Kong University to expand our course portfolios to support the oil and gas industries. We're also developing an MSc in document analysis. In the school itself, our chemistry increased the league position in the Guardian League table, which is fantastic because chemistry was only relaunched in 2007. And in the latest research exercise framework, we were judged world leading. The School of Psychology's reputation for excellence continues with scores 3rd out of 12 in the Northwest universities and 74% of our psychology finalists getting first class honours or 2-1. Psychology continues to have a highly effective formal research relationship with our high secure services with Mersey NHS Trust and the Ashworth Research Centre, headed by Professor Jane Ireland. And the school continues during this very exciting time to appoint new staff to support our students, particularly in the expertise of cognitive neurosciences. But back to you, our graduates here today. Gaining the award you've earned and which we celebrate today is difficult. It must be so. Few things in life of genuine value are easy to gain, and success in higher education is far from easy. The university demands dedication, intellectual endeavor, and hard work from you. I'm sure that many of you here today have had support from your family and friends and colleagues who would have been called upon to provide you with support in the last few years. Could I ask all the graduates today to join me in giving an applause to thank all your family? I know that you would have learned a great deal in your time here at the university, because you would have been taught by a dedicated group of academic staff, many of whom are international leaders in their field, and all of whom devote their professional lives to the teaching, learning, and development of you, our students. You would have also been supported by many dedicated and professional staff members who have provided the services and infrastructures that have made your success possible. I would like you again and the audience, please, to join me in an applause of thanks to our staff at the university. In a few minutes, the names of our graduates will be called out and we will applaud and cheer. You're our final graduation ceremony this week. I've been told by colleagues that you will be very loud and very noisy, so we'll see if that's true. But please make as much noise as you wish. This is a celebratory event. You will come to the stage here on my right as graduands. You will go to the center and shake the hand of our Chancellor, Sir Richard Evans, and you will exit stage left as graduates of this university. Some of you will have personal beliefs and may not wish to shake hands. If that is the case, please just carry your graduation certificate in your right hand, and Sir Richard will be aware that you don't wish to shake hands. You will still be congratulated. And I know the audience will join us in the applause that we have for our first graduate, David Crowder, as we will for our final graduate, Henry Taylor. We take great pride in your achievements while you're here with us, and equally we take great pride in all our graduates who have contributed enormously in a wide range of occupations and professions across the Northwest, the UK, and internationally. I'm confident You will go out into the world and bring real social and economic benefit to yourself, but also to the communities of which you become members. Whatever you decide to do next, and wherever in the world you find yourself, remember, you will always be a member of this university, and I hope at some stage you will return to your academic home. But for now, on behalf of everybody here, very well done, congratulations, and good luck for a happy and successful life. Thank you.
Chancellor, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen. The Academic Board was due to confer an honorary fellowship on Paul Hancock this morning. Paul is the Chief Fire Officer for Cheshire and has unfortunately been called away to a major incident, so we'll look forward to conferring his honorary fellowship at a later date. Chancellor, the presentation of graduands and award holders will now take place.
On behalf of the Academic Board, I present those who have gained awards in the School of Forensic and Investigative Sciences. For a thesis entitled Intent to Aggress in Forensic Settings, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Polly Turner. For a thesis entitled Hazards Presented by Pyrolysis and Combustion Products During Laboratory and Real Incidents, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to David Paul Bertram Crowder. For a thesis entitled Development and Application of An Investigation into the Decontamination of Carbon-14 from Irradiated Graphite, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to James Gill. For a thesis entitled Development and Application of a PCR Multiplex to Assess the Quality and Quantity of Forensic DNA Extracts, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Sisteran Ayavu. For a thesis entitled Development of Fire Retardant Timber Treatments, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Laura Ann Loudon. For a thesis entitled Stereochemical Control of Organic Reactions in the Entomella Region of Cation Exchange Clay Minerals, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Vinod Vishwapathy. For a thesis entitled Towards Bifunctional Sulfur Containing Iron Carbines for hydrogenase mimicking hydrogen storage. The degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Daniel Britton. For a thesis entitled Using Vibrational Spectroscopy to Analyze the Effect of Environmental Aging on Gel Pen Inks, the degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Lucas Durney. For a thesis entitled Carbon Nanotubes for the Stabilization of Lipid Nanostructured Particles, the degree of Master of Science by Research is awarded to Nicholas Philip Gaunt. Master of Chemistry in Chemistry, Dimitar Bakalov. Aisha Bismawa. Benjamin Brewis. Hussein Books. Christopher Deans. Lauren Marie Galligan. Stuart Adam Henry. With the school prize for Best MChem Student and for Best MChem Project, Theodore James Hester. Roxana Elizabeth Jawalska. Leanne Chelsea Jenkins. Jack Alexander Kelly. Jonathan Michael Snodgrass. Alexander Marks. Sean Thomas McKenna. Daniel Rowbottom. Bradley Seddon. Sarah Louise Wignall. Master of Science in Archaeology, with the School Prize for Best Archaeology Student and John G. Evans Award for Best Archaeology Dissertation, Kayla Jean Carter. Thomas Edward Dew. Shanice Jackson. Daniel Joseph Kennedy. Samuel McCormick. Gwendolyn Ellen Edith Naylor. Harry Michael Thompson. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Archaeology, Joshua Michael Pugh. Paul Simpkins. Constance Tisontas. Master of Science in Fire Safety Engineering, Andrew Lawrence Daniel Ford. Abdul Nawudu. Brian Neil Harvey. Patrick William Harvey. Violetta Kubica. Andrew Locke. With the school prize for the best fire dissertation, Bruce Patterson. Neil Perry. With the school prize for the Fire Co Limited Award for Best BEng Fire Engineering Student, Alexander William Thompson. Damien Paul Watts. Bachelor of Engineering with Honours in Fire in Safety Engineering, Wirola Adileo Adebayo. Saad Adib S. Abuain Ain. Suman Jagnathan. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Archaeology, Naqib Aslam. Curtis Barlow. Chloe Louise Brown. Matthew Phillips. Emily Ruth Woolnough. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Chemistry, Michael Briscoe. Ben Chetter. Minaz Dabab Bey. Fahima Kabrihari. With the Royal Society of Chemistry Prize for Best Graduating Chemist and Centre for Material Science Prize for Best Chemistry Project, Simon Andrew Reed. Miriam Siddiqui. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Fire and Leadership Studies, with the Peter Holland Prize for Best Fire and Leadership Fire Dissertation, Christopher Jack Archer. Robert Bray. Ryan Brown. Thomas Nicholas Ian Buckley. Liam Ashley Davis. Samuel Randall John Davis. Samuel Timothy Dillahoyd. Stuart Douglas Forshaw. James Giblin. James Thomas Harris. Oliver Lawrence. Nathan Ledwards. Francis William Lee. Liam Lockyer. Martin Logue. Adam O'Dowd. Samantha Preddy. Daniel Christopher Quinlan. Michael Roscoe. With the school prize for best fire and leadership student based on best average percentage mark, David Michael Shawcroft. Lindsay Salisky. Mark Smith. Brian Andrew Steedman. Robert John Walling. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Fire Safety Engineering. Anwar Juma Saad Salim Al-Masharafri. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Fire Safety and Risk Management, Abdulaziz Karusha. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Forensic Biology, Heather Rose Bibby. Harry Croft. Lisa Henry. Ryan Langdon. Thomas Ousley. Luke Thompson. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Forensic Chemistry, James Parsonage. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Forensic Science, Yasmin Faye Adejuru. Nikki Barber. Dale Joseph Brealey. Jennifer Ellum. Lorraine G. Walder Mastura K. Anila Khan. Philip Mitchell. Lisa Ann Owen. Charlotte Rachel Parkinson. Oliver Rostron. Amy Louise Rushworth. Victoria Catherine Sutton. Joshua Ward. Stephen James Winter. Bachelor of Science in Forensic Science, Shazred Ushan. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Forensic Science and Anthropology, Alice Emily Brown. Erin Burns. Molly Butler Walsh. Ella Rose Clark. Rebecca Louisa Alexandra Cook. Thelma Orlando Fernandez. Amy Fisher. Christopher Hardacre. Catherine Hollywell. Rebecca Kate McGarry. Rebecca McLernan. Claire Ann Moffat. With the Dr. Norman Weston School Prize for Best Forensic Science Dissertation, Marlene Justin Pillar. Lucy Reeder. Aisha Riemann. William James Watkins. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Forensic Science and Criminal Investigation, Lauren Beresford. Robin Louise Birchall. Jessica Bryan. Fiona Burke. Penny Marie Cole. Christina Emma Darker. Jane Fletcher. Holly Hughes. Olivia Donna Hislop. With the Lancashire Partnership Against Crime Prize for Best Police and Criminal Investigation Dissertation, Jenny Elisa Kenneran. Olivia Lofthouse. Rebecca Lowes. George McDonald. Christopher McManus. Lucy Rowley. Alexander Rose. Victoria Ann Saunders. Sam Schofield. With the School Prize for Best Forensic Science and Criminal Investigation Student and for Best Forensic Science Student, Zanim Shabir Suji. Laura Swindles. Aidan Jordan Tibbins. Amy Walsh. Chloe Walsh. Georgina Weir. Connor Whiteside. Rhys Williams, Andrew Wood, Emily Grace Woods, Bachelor of Science with Honours in Policing and Criminal Investigation, James Edwin Ahern, Carice Ali, Kamran Bashir, Oliver Bailiff, Jenna Lee Benson, Amir Baloda, Emma Rose Bloomfield, Joshua Bridge, Megan Brooks, Jordan James Bruce, Liam Carr, Annabelle Jane Caton, Amber Cobb, Andrew Thomas Career, Adam Critchley, Ryan James Cunliffe, Sam Dennis, Jonathan Durrow, Jennifer Evers, Amy Fogarty, Declan G, Chloe Louise Hack, Craig Henderson, Louisa Hodgson, Myphony Kirkwood, Sarah Hessen Margerson, Amy Mowers, Rebecca Mayers, with the school prize for best BSc Policing and Criminal Investigation student, Alana Jade Miles, James Motley, Alice Rose Perry, Stephen Quick, George Roberts, Jack Simpson, Hannah Elizabeth Slight, Katie Smith, James Somerville, Daniel Stewart, Jessica Taylor, James Vincent, Oliver Williams, Abigail Winwood, Foundation degree in Forensic Science, Emma Gallagher, Foundation degree in Science in Policing, Adam Amos, Ryan Arnold, Umar Asmal, Georgina Violet Gis-Belon. Peter Barracliffe. Joshua Bevis. Joseph John Bloomfield. Samuel Bolton. Rachel Bond. Richard Bottomley. Molly Alex Bowden. Jake Brown. Niall Reese Caddy. Liam Couch. Zoe Rebecca Davis. Thomas Eves. Amar Farouk. Georgia Fitzpatrick. Hannah Rebecca Fryer. Mark Gardner. Jackie Godden. Catherine Grogan. Nathan Guy. Joshua James Hamer. Charlotte Julie Harmer. Susie Harris. Jordan Bradley Harrison. Amy Alicia Harvey. Andrew Holder. Alexander James Horsfield. Daniel Thomas Housedyke. Emily Claire Jackson. Connor Martin. Adam Daniel Lamb. Matthew Martin. Andrew Mitchell. Benjamin Moulton. Daryl Murray. Nicola Keely Neal. Holly Jermaine Normanton. Tunk Ostuk. Sheradine Lees Pike. Natasha Elsie Rawlinson. James Rear. Amy Louise Richardson. Carwin Leah Roberts. James Rowe. Hannah Seddon. Chloe Ellen Sewell. Libby Florence Shankland. Donamic Adam Smith. Paige Jordana Teague. David Taylor. Christopher Thompson, Katie Toole, Nathan Adam Waite, Shannon Walsh, Ella Warburton, Jamie Waterhouse, Beth Rachel Weirmouth, Abby Weber, Jonathan Wells, Sean Whitaker, Phoebe Whittington, Tony Wilson, Joel Withington, Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of awards from the School of Forensic and Investigative Sciences.
On behalf of the Academic Board, I present those who have gained awards in the School of Psychology. For a thesis entitled The Use of Think Aloud Protocol to Investigate Golfers' Decision-Making Processes, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to Amy Whitehead. Master of Science in Psychology, Margaret Ann Logan. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Combined Studies, Rabina Begum. With the Jane Hutchinson Memorial Prize for Overall Highest Project Mark in Educational Psychology, Lisa Jane Brown. Danielle Carlton. Faye Michelle Ibbotson. Holly Louise Jax. Cho Yi Mo. Tony Ann Parkinson. Hamza Patel. Francesca J. Louise Shaw. Rebecca Jane Sissons. And with the Mentor of the Year Award, Robert Michael Smith. Amy Speed. Jody Louise Wexler. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Forensic Psychology, Tony Marie Andrew. Karina Nicole Baines. Danica Breakspear Smith. Lauren Elizabeth Bridgestock. Hannah Louise Brooke. And with the Hugh Wagner Memorial Prize for Overall Highest Project Mark in the School, Sophie Elizabeth Coleman. Rebecca Cook. Kiri Cresswell Gallagher. Louisa Hannah Date. Simone Davies. Jenna Fergus, Catherine Patricia Gordon, Louise Gorham, Michelle Hadwin, Jonathan Hall, Rafferty Hibbert, Abigail Sean Hopwood, Gail Elizabeth James, Hannah Sophia Jordan, Lauren Kershaw, Rachie Kelly McIntyre, Sam Martin, Desiree Stella McClelland, Alice McLinden, Dagmara Mikotowska, Mina Omar, Charlotte Ormston, Daniel David Owens, Hanumanth Ramesh, Sophie Sindel White, Jennifer Skeggs, Lauren Smith, Ryan Smith, Lauren Elizabeth Taylor, with the British Psychological Society Undergraduate Award for overall highest mark within the school and the Dean's Award for Academic Excellence for Best Overall Finalist in Forensic Psychology and the Hugh Wagner Memorial Prize for overall highest project mark, Rhiannon Thompson. Lauren Rebecca Voice. Natasha Rose Ward. Robert Wiles. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Health Psychology, Nicola Bontz. Fiona Catherine Sanchez. Amy Sherratt. Sophie Smith, with the Dean's Award for Academic Merit for Best Overall Finalist on Health Psychology, Victoria Jacobi, Serish Yamin, Bachelor of Science with Honours in Neuropsychology, Grace Olawofun Milayo Adewayu. Victoria Louise Bennett. Rebecca Cooper. Summit Day, Olivia Grace Elsie, Lisa Foster, Heather Holding, Ikram Hussein. Farah Khan. Jennifer Ann Lord. Alice Noble. Chloe Louise Page. Lubna Patel. Rafia Patel. Kirtana Rajakumaran. Anthony Sharp. Khatija Tulkubra. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Neuroscience, Grace Adele Bailey. Thomas David Barrett. Samuel Thomas Casford. And with the School Award for Best Project in Neuroscience, Charlotte Freeman. Oliver Lewis Hacking. Tae Gwen Kwan. David Little. Christopher Neal. Shreya Patel. With the Dean's Award for Academic Excellence for Best Overall Finalist in Neuroscience, Matthew Plummer. David Romero Perez. Rosemary Taylor. Bachelor of Science with Honours in Psychology, Isa Abbas. Andriana Adrazikaki. Jessica Arnold. Sidra Arshid. Laura Jane Austell. Lisa Bithell. Sophie Bithell. Rachel Blackledge. Jenna Blinkhorn. Courtney May Broadbelt. Melissa Bromley. Richard Bullen. Jonathan Philip Butterworth. Eliza Canuti. Samantha Jolene Capon. Jack Chambers. Sitikon Charo Enkajonkel. Sheridan Clayton. Rachel Connolly. Rachel Louise Corbett. Adela Wynne Cox. Shannon Mary Craig. Ludmila Kogut. Sarah Grace Cunningham. Emily Davenport. Anna Dean, Kaylee Delaney, Alice Dillon, Carly Dillon Morris, Robert Durnbreck, Alexander Ellison, Maria Francine Gallagher, Thomas George, Simon Andrew Gosling, Larissa Hardesty, Abdikani Hassan, Keris Jane Herbert, Wenying He, Charlotte Howarth, Danielle Jade Hunt, Kirsty Lynn Jones, Paul Kershaw, Zahifa Arshad Khan, Jennifer Alice Karowski, Megan Jane Lawless, Nicola Lovett, Richard Lowe, Kim Heather McAllister, Danielle McCabe, Sean and Elizabeth McCartan, Carly Jade McDanielson, Rory McNeese, Sana Mehmood, Masa Mizam Hussein Barzi, Bethany Mole, Maria Musa, Zara Maria, Mark Moss, Sabina Moyo, Amar Musaid, Yuen Q Eng, with the Dean's Award for Academic Excellence for Best Overall Finalist on Psychology, Amy Porter. Susan Proctor, Alison Fury Ritchie, Haley Leanne Robson, Jade Roddy, Laura Roscoe, Lauren Ashley Sandham, Emma Louise Shearing, Alicia Thompson, Jennifer Thornber, Tamara Jane Wenham, with the Hugh Wagner Memorial Prize for Overall Highest Project Mark in the School, Paul Tidy. William Peter John Tyson, Juliet Walker, Jessica Warboys, Rachel Ward, Catherine West, Sally Williamson, Daniel Wilson, Pingwei Yong, Bachelor of Science with Honours in Sports Psychology, Dean Grindrod, Jack Heard, with the overall Dean's Award for Academic Excellence for Best Overall Finalist on Sport and Exercise Psychology, Joseph Husbands. Joseph Nicholson. Ryan Pelling. Alicia Robson. Kelly Stainer. Henry Taylor. Emmanuel Lutri Salami. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of awards from the School of Psychology.
Chancellor, the presentations are completed. I call on Lucy Hay, Officer of the Students' Union at the University of Central Lancashire, to respond on behalf of those awarded today.
Vice-Chancellor, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, I'm honoured to address you all today on this special occasion, even more so because I was a student within the School of Forensic and Investigative Sciences, so a huge shout out today to the PCI students. But I would like to congratulate each of you sat before me on your achievement. The people we've met and the experiences we have created are what makes each of our journeys to graduation unique and special. For most of us, studying is only one part of university life, and whether you're a course rep, join a sports team, were a member of a society, or moved away from home, it has contributed to the graduate that you are today. As graduates of the University of Central Lancashire, each of you strengthen UCLan's worldwide alumni network. Today's award is a landmark in your personal and professional development, which is a hard-earned stepping stone to your future success. The real world might seem like a scary place, and right now for some of you it might feel like you're in limbo. But it's time to aim high, grab all those opportunities, and accept a challenge, because that degree that you hold in your hands today is really just your learner's permit for the rest of your drive through life. Cheesy, I know. Remember, you don't have to be smarter than the next person. All you have to be willing to do is work harder. Because let me tell you something you already know, nothing worth having comes easy. Last but not least, I would like to thank the parents, siblings, friends and partners that have joined you here today and supported you throughout your UCLan journey. And let's not forget all the lecturers and university staff whose dedication has helped you to succeed. I wish you all the best for the future UCLan class of 2015. Now go and celebrate because you truly deserve it. Thank you.
In a moment, we'll hear from the University of Central Lancashire Chamber Choir. The members of the University Chamber Choir are all students of music theatre within the School of Art, Design and Performance, where Mark Goggins is both course leader and choir director. The university is extremely proud of the growing reputation and success of the Chamber Choir. In recent years, the Chamber Choir has won national competitions, including the BBC Radio 3 Adult Choir of the Year. The Chamber Choir has a well-established annual tour of the southwest of France and has sung at other overseas venues, including at one of our partner institutions in Shanghai. The Chamber Choir has performed on BBC One, BBC Four, and on BBC Radio 3. As well as performing at prestigious venues such as the Royal Festival Hall, the Birmingham Symphony Hall, and the Bridgewater Hall, the Chamber Choir has also performed at many local civic and fundraising events, including concerts with local schools and colleges. This morning, the Chamber Choir will sing Happy by Pharrell Williams.
Thank you, Choir.
Chancellor,
honored guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen. When I graduated, which wasn't perhaps last year or even the year before that, somebody stood up at the end to deliver a speech. And the dear old boy went on for about an hour and a half, I expect, on the rights, responsibilities, and privileges of being a graduate. Well, as it turned out, there weren't any rights really to speak of. There were lots of responsibilities, and I'm certainly not going to dwell on those on a day of celebration like this. And then we turned to privileges, and it is still a privilege to graduate from a university such as this, and it's certainly our privilege to support you to get there. We're going to celebrate that today in the traditional manner. The traditional manner goes a little like this. In a moment, I'm going to invite all the graduates to stand up. I'm going to invite everyone else in the hall to give three hearty cheers, and on the third cheer, all the graduates will throw their hats into the air. Now, before we do that, I'm just going to offer one word of advice. As the years roll by, I notice that all of us want pretty much the same thing. Doesn't matter whether you're young or old, rich or poor, black or white, we all want the same things out of life. And today in particular, we all want the same thing. We all want the deposit back on the hat. Can I ask the graduates please to stand? And we celebrate your magnificent achievement. Hip, hip! Hip, hip! Hip, hip! Hip, hip! Well done. Come on. Can I ask you please to sit down now for the Chancellor?
Okay, everybody. It's important you have a cap. It doesn't matter whose it is, but make sure you've got one when you leave here. Well, as we bring this ceremony to a close, I'd just like to add my personal congratulations again to all of you award holders. You're absolutely fantastic people, and I know you're going to do well in the world when you get out there. The subject knowledge that you've all gained during your time here at the university is going to serve you well in meeting many of the challenges that lie ahead. However, we all hope that your time at the university has also given you something more. We hope you've developed a desire for learning and a recognition that learning is a lifetime activity. In the ever-changing world in which we now live, nobody can acquire sufficient knowledge in just one period of learning. So we hope that periodically you will want to return to study, to update your knowledge and your skills, and that you will return here to this, which is your university. There are many people who've been working behind the scenes in order to make our ceremonies here and the ceremony this morning so memorable and so special. And I want to put on my record my personal thanks to all of them. Some people are here with us today. There are many others who are not here. Without them, we cannot actually enjoy ceremonies such as this. And thank you, wherever you are, to all of you, very, very much indeed. And of course, thank you to all of you people for coming. And we just hope that you've enjoyed this morning's ceremony as much as we ourselves here on the platform have. And we hope that you'll have an opportunity to be able to stay for some refreshments in the university after the ceremony finishes. Enjoy the rest of the day, and all of you have a very safe and happy journey home. Thank you very much indeed.
Can I ask you now please to stand for the national anthem? Please be seated. We'll now continue to celebrate the success of today's graduates at the university's Foster Building, and your gowns can be left at Foster Building after the event. Can I ask now that you please remain seated until the platform party has left the hall? Thank you all.